there is a saying that the more you sweat in peace, less you bleed in a war. So that's exactly what happened to me. And you know, when I gave the mock test in the lab, they just, when I went to actually attempt the exam, it was just like a cakewalk.
Hey everybody, Varun here from Language Academy. Guys, what a great day. I've got Sandeep sitting next to me. Perfect score in PT. Everything on his scorecard is 90. Each and everything is 90. And this is very rare. I've never seen this before. Congratulations, Sandeep. Very well done. This is one of the achievements I'll say you should always be proud of, right? Highest score in the world, I'll say, you cannot get more than that. There are a lot of questions I have in my mind because it's very rare I get to sit with someone who has got a perfect score in PT. And there's students out there who are preparing for the exams. They've got a lot of questions. I've collected all of them and really need to ask all the questions.
Sure. Right?
First of all, what do you think is the most important part when it comes to not only clearing PT with 79, but getting a perfect score?
I mean, the most important thing I would like to say is, to have the courage to do it and to have the confidence in yourself that you can do it. That's the first step towards it. Mm-hmm. And everything else comes second.
That's right. That's right.
And for me, what worked out is like when I went through the door of Language Academy, that was a turning point of me. And the six subsequent things built upon my success.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how I achieved this.
The process was very important.
The process was very important. Mm-hmm. How my journey was like. It started from building the concepts and working on those things day by day, night by night. Mm-hmm. So that's how it worked out, and I achieved the speed of 90. Though I never meant for achieving all 90s, mm-hmm. but it happened.
Definitely. Thanks to God. One thing: do you think you did each and everything perfect in the exam?
No, I don't feel that I did everything perfect in the exam. There were a few gray areas I felt I was doubtful about, but it actually happened. Mm-hmm. I don't know so how the algorithm works, mm-hmm. but yeah, I believe in the process that I did something right,
mm-hmm.
and now I achieved
it. See, that is one thing we always emphasize: to get a perfect score, you don't really need to be perfect. I remember when you used to mess up your repeat sentences, you used to ask me how I'm going to get the score, right?
Yeah.
But yes, as long as you're satisfying the algorithm, you are going to get the score. And yes, even after you make a few mistakes, you can get a perfect 90. Another thing, were your repeat sentences perfect? Do you think you had each and everything? Because a lot of times students, what they stress about, if I miss one word, will I get the score? If I miss two words, will I get the score? Do you think your repeat sentences were 100%?
So no, I think my repeat sentences were about 85 to 90% correct.
Mm.
So I did make few mistakes,
mm.
But yeah. But the overall mm. the picture was that I did speaking really well.
Mm.
So it was kind of flawless. And though in the mock test when I used to give in the lab, they were not flawless. I used to, have a pause somewhere in my speaking.
Mm.
But that's what happened. That's the power of mock test,
yes,
right. So they prepare you well for the D-Day.
That's what I said. That's very correct that even if you repeat around 85% of the content, 90% of the content, you can get the score. Because let's be very practical, it's not possible to repeat 100% of the content.
Right.
It is not possible to repeat 100% of the content. So it's very, very important, very crucial that you understand what the computer is looking for and then give the particular thing back to the computer and you're going to get the score. Right from dictation, what did you do in that?
So right from dictation, then the strategies which Varun and the whole faculty told me that I exactly implemented that. You want to discuss the details?
Yeah,
so if you hear a word, let's say economy, so probably the word could be economies, or the accent is so like that you didn't hear it so well, but the word is something related to economy.
Mm-hmm.
So you write economy, economics, or economies. There are three words, so three alternatives of that. I wrote all of them.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I think that worked for me.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Because whenever we tell anyone that you can add extra words, they think there's negative marking. But if it would have been marked negatively, you wouldn't have got this score, right?
Yeah.
So that's very, very important. You follow the right strategies and do something which is proven and which will help you get over the line. When it comes to reading, how did you practice reading? What do you think is important for the exam?
Yeah, so I still remember the days of the lab you know, when one of the faculty members, you know, they would give me so 20 fill in the blanks, read and write, and 20 fill in the blanks. So I would say, you know, I knew that I was going to spend 4 minutes or 5 minutes on each of the blanks to understand what's going on and why am I doing it right and why am I doing it wrong. You know, so be looking at this 40 fill in the blanks, and if I multiply that with the 5 minutes, I'm going to spend the night in the lab. So that was worrying. That was worrying for me. But I stick to that approach. I understood the context and I tried to know the meaning of all the blanks, you know. So that's how I worked on it day by day, evening by evening. And that's what I applied in the exam. Yeah.
So basically understanding the context of the passage.
Yeah.
Very, very important. As you understand what is the passage or what is the given fill in the blanks is talking about. If you understand the passage, everything seems to put, you know, fit in the right place.
Yeah.
Because sometimes we are not really familiar with the words, let's be practical. It's not like you're getting 10 options and you will be familiar with 10 of the words. So it's very, very important, very crucial that you understand the context and then based on that, select the right option. Mock tests, you've taken a number of mock tests, I remember. How important are mock tests? How mock tests help you get a perfect time?
Okay. There is a saying that the more you sweat in peace, less you bleed in a war. So that's exactly what happened to me. And you know, when I gave the mock test in the lab, they just, when I went to actually attempt the exam, it was just like a cakewalk. I wouldn't say a complete cakewalk, but I was prepared for it. There wouldn't be any surprises over there because I wasn't cramming anything in the lab, and I was prepared for each and every task. Just thanks to the mocks, power of the mocks, that I went well with the exam, and this is how my results speak up.
That's right. That's it. Surely they do. One thing which I liked is that you have taken the mock test and then you did not focus on cramming anything. Right? Very, very important. You don't just need to cram each and everything and think that if you get something repeated, you'll do it. Otherwise, you know, you'll wait for the next time. That's not the right approach.
Yeah.
Very important. You take the mock test, learn from your mistakes and practice as much as you can. Sandeep, any final piece of advice for students out there? How to get a perfect 90. I won't talk about how to get perfect 79 because getting 79 and getting 92 different stories. How we should aim for a perfect 90.
So I would still like to add another thing that I still remember those days in the lab when I used to sneak out of the lab at, you know, 9 PM and Varun was sitting there and he would say, "Where are you going? Just give another mock test, stop speaking or reading or something." So I was like, let me go at least. So, but those days actually in the lab, they paid off in form of this result, and they were actually worth it. You know?
That's right.
And final piece of advice for our mates is that just put your heart and soul in this because this is your goal. Just don't cram anything. Just focus on understanding the context or apply all the strategies which the faculty of Language Academy has. So, and I think you can achieve it if I can do it as well.
That's right. If he has done it, guys, I have done it, you can do it as well. But you need to go through the process. Put in your hard work. One thing which I learned from him is that he used to follow whatever we used to tell. It's not like I asked him to do a speaking mock test and then he's going home. I still remember you even stayed till 9:30 in the evening, right? You used to be in the lab around 9:30, 9:45 as well. And that is the, you know, amount or level of dedication we need to have.
Yep.
If you need to get something, you need to work hard for it. It's not like you're relaxing and day before the exam you're studying and you expect you get the score. Very important, you give your 120% to whatever you're doing and you are going to do it as well. That's it from this video, guys. Congratulations once again. Very, very proud. What an achievement. That's it, guys. Make sure you keep on practicing. Do not give up. Give your 100% and you are going to get your score as well. Thanks, guys, and see you very soon.